in March of next year. Two heavyweights have won a version of the title in their 40s. Of course, George Foreman, who was 45, and Bob Fitzsimmons, who was 42. Solar plexus punch. Measured approach by both Ortiz and Cojano. But at any time, especially in the heavyweight division, one punch can change everything.
Well, we saw that in the Wilder-Ortiz fight, which was fought at a very slow pace until Wilder got Ortiz hurt, and then Ortiz came back himself. Cojano was, you mentioned how little activity he had in the Parker fight when he fought Parker, who, of course, today lost to Dillian White in what was an exciting fight. He's going to, at some point in this fight, have to be more active.
Well, Cojano with the histrionics, the fans would love to see him throw more punches.
He did that against Parker as well. A lot of mugging, a lot of dramatics, but not so much punching.
Oh, yeah. Cojano has an affable personality.
Yeah, he does.
It's time to go to work, right, Paulie?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, you see the histrionics, you see he's not impressed with Ortiz. He's trying to show him at least he's not impressed, but sometimes you want to show some activity behind that as well.
Of course. Ortiz is good, too.
Yeah, of course. Especially when you're making a guy miss, or if you're blocking a shot and then saying you're not impressed, it's good to come right back with your own shot and show him the way it's done if you're going to do that.
Ortiz, in many ways, auditioning for a rematch against Deontay Wilder. Of course, the much-anticipated unification showdown between Wilder and Anthony Joshua delayed, with Joshua defending against Alexander Povetkin later this year. Deontay Wilder targeted to return this year, and Ortiz targeting Cojano and dropping him.
That's the most Ortiz power.
And that is why Luis Ortiz is known as the boogeyman of the heavyweight division.
That's really heavyweight boxing, you know.
We said it right.
You have a lull in the action, and then boom, one shot, and it's over before anything happens, you know?
He was able to do what Joseph Parker wasn't able to do against Cojano, get him out of there. And that's the kind of performance he wanted, to make sure that he would keep his name in the sweepstakes to fight for a world title again. And he hopes very soon, when you're 39 years old, you want those chances as soon as you can get them.
I think Cojano tried to get up a little too fast. You know, the referee will probably panic a little bit if he sees you trying to get up. I mean, Cojano's arguing. Personally, me, I would have let him get up and then seen if he's okay once he's standing up. But
he was stumbling around.
Yeah, he was stumbling around, but he's still arguing as he's going. So, you know, if he gets up before 10 and then he's stumbling, you can stop it, you know. But at the end of the day, he probably got up a little too fast. You have to know, as a fighter, you have to try to convince.